can't wait until tomorrow. We shall have a grand feast. Father, what time do you want to put up?
Oh, did you not? My father got one too. Well, this is a little rabbit. We're quite lucky, aren't we?
Can we go start with those kids in the boardhouses? They have never celebrated in so long. We could have it so much worse.
I just feel fortunate not staying at the poorhouse. Those poor children have no lives at all. They just go begging on the streets every day.
And those kids don't go to rats everywhere. Maybe that's what they do for Christmas. Rat soup.
Ew!
Yeah!
That is so wrong. There's so many old children in the orphanage. I feel quite bad. I don't have much in the orphanage.
Don't you guys see all those rich people with black shoes and all their lunch? They make me feel so stupid.
That's because you are stupid.
Uncle!
I have arrived for the not-profit. I dare say Christmas among the rest. Though it has never put a scrap of gold in my pocket, I believe it has done me good and will do me good, and I say God bless it.
Ah!
Come, don't be angry. Come, dine with us tomorrow.
I'll dine alone, thank you, but why? Why? Why did you get married? Why? Because I fell in love with a wonderful girl, and I was sold. Good afternoon.
Nay, uncle, I'm sorry with all my heart to find you so determined, but I have made an attempted homage to Christmas, and I plan to keep that good spirit to the last. So Merry Christmas, uncle.
Good afternoon.
And a Happy New Year.
Good afternoon.
Be here all the earlier the next morning.
I will, sir.
Then I'll off. Yes, sir. Merry Christmas.
Bah! Christmas Eve, carolers, bah! There, another day. Jacob, don't leave me! Yes, yes. 12 noon. Black. 12 midnight. I must get up. The day waits here. I must get down to the office. Quarter past, but it just rang 12. 15 minutes haven't gone past, not so quickly. Quarter to 1. 1. Are you the spirit whose coming was foretold me?
I am.
Who and what are you?
I am the ghost of Christmas past.
Long past?
Your past.
Why are you here?
Your welfare.
Right.
Walk.
I am mortal still. I cannot pass the air.
My hand. All students have gone home to the holidays, but there's a lonely child. Reading.
Reading? Oh, it was nothing. Fancy, all fancy and make believe and take me away.
All of it?
Yes. Nonsense.
Alibaba.
Yes, that was it.
Yes, and remember Robinson Crusoe.
And the parrot.
Yes, the parrot. I loved him best.
With his striped green body and yellow tail dripping along and couldn't sing, awk, but could talk. And the thing like a lettuce growing off the top of his head. And he used to sit on the very top of the tree. Up there!
Robinson Crusoe thought the parrot had escaped the island, and the parrot said,
Robinson Crusoe, where you been? Awk, Robinson Crusoe, where you been?
Robinson Crusoe looked up in the tree. He knew the parrot had escaped the island, but was there still. Oh, God.
Poor Robinson Crusoe.
Poor Robinson Crusoe.
Poor child. Poor child.
Why poor?
It's his way, a child's way, to lose being alone in dreams. Never matter if they're all nonsense, yes, nonsense. But he'll be all right, grow out of it. Yes, yes, he did outgrow the nonsense. Became a man and left there and he became successful, rich. Never matter. Faye!
Brother, dear Finn. I've come to bring you along, home for good and ever. Come with me, come now. Father isn't nearly as mean as he used to be, and he wants to see you. Please come with me, we'll have a great holiday together.
Let me watch them go. Let them be happy for a moment. A delicate child. The breath might have withered her.
She died a woman and had, if I remember, children.
One child.
Your nephew.
Yes, yes, Fred, my nephew. Well, all of us have that, haven't we? Childhoods, sadnesses. But we've grown, we've become men, masters of ourselves.
Come view another festive scene, the past.
I've no time for it, spirit. Music and all of your Christmas fol-de-rol. Yes, yes, I've learned what you have to show me.
Thank you.
us, Quibble, for the Christmas celebration.
Yes, indeed, Mr. President. We shall have a grand feast on this December 24th.
This is the most exciting time of year. How great to be all around such a wonderful man.
He's a jolly man. He's always sharing with his daughter.
Indeed, you are. Now let's take a bunch of work and finish our preparations. Oh, Mrs. Gazzini, you are indeed inclined to cook this side of the event.
Why, thank you, Mr. Douglas. Now I can join this wonderful Christmas celebration.
Thank you.
are you?
Mr. Scrooge. You've never seen the lights of me before. I'm the ghost of Christmas present. But you will see what you will see, Scrooge. No more. Will you walk out with me this Christmas Eve?
But I'm not yet dressed.
Take my tails, dear boy. We're leaving.
Wait, what is it now?
Christmas present, did you say? I did.
Then we are traveling here in this town? London, just down there?
Yes, yes, of course.
Then we can walk? Your flying is slow, too sudden for a holy man.
It is your Christmas, Scrooge. I am only the guide.
Then we can walk? Where are you guiding me to?
Bob Cratchit's.
My lord.
You did want to talk with him? Don't worry, Scrooge, you won't have to.
Shouldn't be much of a trip with $15 a week. How far off can it be?
A world away, Scrooge. At least that far.
Thank you. really sucked.
What's the ghost of Christmas yet to come? Speak to me. What is happening to all of us?
Did you take a child and set him in the midst of it?
The light tires my eyes, though. They're better now. It makes them tired to try to see by the firelight, and I wouldn't want to show red knives to your father when he comes home for the world. It must be near his time now.
Past it, I think. You walk slower than you used these past few days, Mother.
I've grown to walk with Tiny Tim upon his shoulders very fast indeed.
And so have I, often.
And so have I.
But he was very light to carry, and your father loved him so that was no trouble, no trouble. And there's your father at the door.
My dear, Peter, how's it coming?
Nearly done.
I'm sure it will be done long before Sunday.
Sunday? You went today then, Robert?
Yes, it would have done you good to see how great it is, but I promised him that he would see it often.
We mustn't hurt ourselves over it.
No, you wouldn't have wanted that. You wouldn't have guessed who I'd run into. Scrooge's nephew, Fred, said that he was sorry and he'd give his respect to my good wife. Wonder how he knew that.
Knew what, dear?
Why, that you were a good wife. Everybody knows that, Mother. You've gone through the entire life to raising us children. But now Jim sure life here is blessed out of the mother. And he gave me his card. And Peter, I wouldn't be surprised if he got you a position.
Only hear that, Peter.
Well, he will. And soon you'll be setting up with some young girl. And setting up for yourself.
A lot?
Well, it will happen one day, but when that day does come, we must not forget the first part of our family, our little tiny kid.
Allow me to ask your pardon, and will you have the goodness to add this?
to your good work.
My dear Mr. Scrooge, are you serious?
If you please, not a penny less. The bread money back payments are included in it, I assure you. Would you do me that favor?
My dear sir, I don't know what I can say to such generosity.
Say nothing. Accept it. Come and see me. Will you come and see me?
I will.
Thank you. I thank you 50 times. I am much obliged to you. God bless you and Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, sir.
Now, which is the way to that nephew's house?
Thank you.